Hello everyone, it's me, Heather Feather. I would like to do another sound assortment video for you today. It's pretty late, so my voice might be a little gritty and tired. What can you do? The first thing I'd like to show you is this teapot. I used this in an older video, I think with my old camera, and I wanted to see if you guys liked the sounds with it. It's black clay, I believe. Oh, cool. Not microwave safe. Dishwasher safe. Made in China. The inside is really pretty, shiny green, as is the lip right here. The handle is some kind of wood. It's bound with wire. Gorgeous to me. I love it. It's green. It's light green. And then dark green. And it's crackled. I love crackled glass. I think it's gorgeous. Can you see it good? I hope you can. It's so beautiful. Smooth. It's really smooth. And it fits neatly on the teapot like that. The spout is also green, but it's more mint. Things that I own have come from garage sales or flea markets. A lot of my home decor is from flea markets. I also have this cup. It's a little dusty on inside. It has flowers, and it's a really nice color blue. This was painted, hand-painted, and put in a kiln and baked. How do I know? I did not do this. I used to go to I guess it's a pottery painting place. I used to paint pottery, and then the place would fire it for you, and you just paid for the object. They would supply you with the glazes and things like that, and bake it for you. And someone made an awesome piece of an Oriental woman. She was from, because I have no idea. How can I know that? But it's gorgeous, and it was a plate. It was a sushi plate, and I loved it. And it had this cup, and two cups with it. And it was so beautiful. And I asked the shop owner who did that, because I wanted to commission them to make one for me. And they said it was an employee that did it. And I asked if it was for sale, and the employee said sure, and so I bought it all. I have have a thing for art with women in it. I think that's just beautiful. So, just trying to get this dust out. Whisper talking. I'll try to talk regular. Pour you a cup of tea if you'd like. More? I don't know if I mentioned this, but it might look like I'm in my bathroom, and I'm not. I'm in the area that I usually do my medical roleplays in, and it's actually part of my living room. It's this weird little alcove with a sink. I'm actually at my dining room table, and just two seats away from me is where I do my sound assortment videos usually. A lot of people ask, why are you filming in your bathroom, or where's the toilet, or things like that, and there's no toilet. It's just this weird little part of my house. I showed a picture of it in a blog entry a long time ago. I'll post it in the description so you can see what I'm talking about. You don't think I'm fibbing. Sorry guys, you know this is gonna happen. I have to fix the hair. Okay. I think we're good. Alright. So that was the teapot and the tea. I hope you enjoy it. You can continue to sip on it while I show you a mess of poop. The tin back. This is full of Pokemon cards. And the response to the Pokemon cards was really positive. So I'm just gonna go through them with you guys. I'm trying not to be loud. Looks crazy. I don't have space. positive we did these last time. Oh, no, we didn't. First one. Success. From Pikachu's Vacation. With Cubone's help. Let me hold this right here. With Cubone's help, Charizard is freed and goes soaring through the air with Psyduck still holding the rope. As the two go careening through the sky, a very sleepy Meowth tries to nap. Is once again disturbed by the excitement. Meowth lights a bomb and prepares to hurl it at the other Pokemon, but out of nowhere, Charizard lands on top of him and the bomb blows up under Charizard's rear end. Exclamation point. That's zany. Zany. There's Pikachu. On to the car. These are all the ones that were on just dropped a bunch that were on the top. I'm gonna move them to the side and just take a handful from the bottom. And we'll go down that way. Sound good? Shelter, energy. Nidoran. It's like a little rat. It's a poison pin Pokemon. It weighs 15 pounds. Aww, and it calls for its family. That's so cute. Meowth. Can't read that. Pocket Monsters card game. Is this like an imitation thing? Or is this like legit? John, I'll say. Crabby. Onyx. I think Brock had Onyx. Brock. Yeah.
Kadabra.
No, Tentacool. And then there's Tentacruel. That was Tentacool. No! Tentacruel. Didn't it sound like
Tentacruel?
I think it did. Energy. Ponyta. Pretty. Shelter. Psyduck. Veteran. Energy. Pink. Tangela. Or Tangela. I never saw an episode with this Pokemon. I also don't like it. But are you? I think that was Misty's Pokemon. Tentacruel on the top. Charmeleon. He was so snarky. Diglett. Sandslash. Looking Pokemon. I'm not gonna say it. Dark Dugtrio. Onyx and Seedra. more. I've got all the time in the world. I don't know if I have very many different ones though for you. Poor side. Reminds me of someone I know who always has headaches. Sorry guys, they're all in different directions. I just want to fix it. Hi, Duck. The arena. And the game. Drain. Persian. Stage 1, Goldine, yep. Mofo. Trainer. Lick a tongue. Wow. So many Geodudes. Honestly, who throws a shoe? Ponyta. Meow. Meow. Tentacle. Ponyta. Energy. Ratatata. Nidorino. Sandshrew, who eventually becomes Sandslash, if I'm correct. Rattata. I thought it was rat-a-tat. I might have been saying it wrong the whole time, I'm not sure. Cool duck. Is who Psyduck would eventually become. Oddish. Oh, I hate this thing. Spearow? They're so grumpy. Dark Raticate? There's a lot of Pokemon, and I only seem to have like 10 of the same kind. Gloom? Did I show you Gloom? Gloom is a drooling fungus. The fluid that oozes from its mouth isn't drool, it is a nectar that is used to attract a prey. That's gonna be it for the Pokemon cards, because I seem to have just like Geodude, Psyduck, Zubat, and the rats. Yep. So next, I want to brush my hair. People keep asking me for more hair brushing videos, and I'm not going to be doing them for a long time, because the one I did was already so long, and it's a little boring for me to do for a long time. So I tried to add a little bit of it in my videos. Is a syringe thing that I will be using in an upcoming dental exam roleplay. Monoject. It's, put it in your mouth and it just flushes. You put water in, and then water comes out that little spout, and you just flush out an area. It makes pretty cool sounds. And so if you had like a tooth removed or a canker sore, My back hurts. So, let's do some... We just did paper and air elastic. So, let's do water. You guys have seen this before. If you watched some of the older videos. My grandparents bought this for me a long time ago when I was really young. It's just a bottle of water. It's not even full anymore, even though I haven't opened it. And I couldn't bear to open it because it was so pretty to me. I love this color, cobalt blue. It's one of my favorite colors ever. So I've just had this bottle in my room forever. It has a little water droplet in the glass. It's the shape of a teardrop or a drop of water. It's really beautiful. On the bottom it says numbers, and over here it says Aqua de la Madonna. Natural mineral water with natural carbonation. This is carbonated. It says bottled at the source, Castellamare, Italy. So old that the glue is gone off the labels. It's falling off. San Clemente, California. Imported. Product of Italy. Expiration date 9/29/2001. Product date 9/29/1998. I was in 8th grade. Then, yeah. I really like the sounds it makes when you turn it. beautiful blue bottle of water. So pretty. Okay. Next, I have, what should we do? What should we do? We should do what? Oh, let me show you this really quick. It's not for very many sounds, but I told you I would show you it. This is my tiara from prom. I wore this to prom. I still have it. It's not real or anything like that. It's just really sparkly. See? That looks ridiculous. And then I have my hair like an updo with like a little curl tendrils. Let me see if I can mimic it. Scratch it or anything, because I'm afraid of taking out the little rhinestones or crystals or whatever they are. I just wanted to show you though. Okay, I'm just going to look in this little thing to make sure I don't look crazy. I would like to use chopsticks on your face. My mom bought these for me at an estate sale. I'm a huge sushi person. I love sushi. It's like fish candy to me. Nom 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 nom. Just thinking about it makes me want it. Favorite is tuna roll, just plain tuna roll, not spicy tuna, just plain. I love it. I love it so much. I would take a bath in it and I would eat my way out of the bath. Then my next favorite. What's my next favorite? Eel. I like specialty rolls that are unique to certain places with crab and tuna and avocado and sauce and seeds. I really want sushi now. And I love the salad, the avocado salad with the spicy sauce as a dressing. And it's avocado and lettuce and tomatoes and all these things that I just drench in this spicy stuff and I eat it all like. Did you guys know I like sushi? Because I do, and I like the salad. Should not do videos this late. had this box. Our chopsticks. I'll show you. There's two of them, two pairs. Both pairs are connected with a chain. And this one has twirly design into it. So, I'd like to chopstick you, if you don't mind. Let's pretend you are made of sushi. Pieces off your face and eat it. Remember? Why am I doing this? Remember when you were little and an adult would grab your nose and then say, "Got your nose," and eat it? I'm gonna do that. Got your nose. Okay. You could have it back. Use chopsticks, I'll show you. I didn't know how to do it for the longest time. I had people try to teach me and it didn't work, and then it's actually the boy from the Draw My Life video who I met in high school. He taught me how to do it. So you put one in your hand, just where your thumb is, that's it. That one's not really gonna do anything. And then you put your You hold it like this. And then you hold this one with your thumb and your pointer finger. And this is the one that does all the work. This one just stays stationary. So you just move it with your thumb and your finger. And that's how you pick things up. Let me show you. If I have anything little that I can pick up. Matches. My matches. I don't really have anything small around here. Pokemon cards. It's actually really hard because these are so smooth. I don't think these are made to eat with. I would never eat with them. Same kind of chain connecting them, except these have a different design. The twirly part is smaller and down there, and then it's it looks to be seaweed carved or etched into them. I have hit this microphone so many times tonight. There you have them. do one more thing. I didn't use that many objects in this assortment video, but I think I spent a lot of time on especially the Pokemon cards, so. Because according to the camera, I've been doing this for an hour. So I'll do one more. Okay. PSP. Ta-da! I bought this specifically for Birth by Sleep, the Kingdom Hearts game. It's a great game. I have a huge thing for Kingdom Hearts. It's my favorite game series of all time. If you haven't played it and you have been thinking about playing it, you should definitely play it. Some people are turned off by the fact that it has Disney characters in it, and I can tell you that the Disney characters are supporting characters. The main characters are not Disney characters, but they support in the game in a very relevant way, and the storylines that you contribute to with them are really good. There's also Final Fantasy characters in it, all over the place. Sephiroth is there, Cloud, Yuffie, Tifa, Leon, lots of them. And the game is one of those games that just, it's a really deep game series. There's a lot of metaphors, and the story itself is, it'll get you, it'll get you right in the heart, and you won't forget about it. PSP for Kingdom Hearts. Here's your screen. The screen's actually really good as far as graphics go, at least with Birth by Sleep. You have the two buttons up here. What's that? What is that a reflection of? Oh, whoa. That's me showing you the PSP screen. And that's a, it's PSP Inception. That's cool. Yeah. You turn it on over here. It's a sliding thing, so you just go boom, and then it would turn on, but my battery is dead. You open it up here, and there's a game cartridge. That's what they look like. You don't take out the disc. I tried. Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep. It has a little arrow right there. Tells you to put it in this way. So you open this up. Put it in like that. And then you play. Your standard buttons. And then that's your analog stick right here. Even though it's not very high. So I'm just gonna press the buttons around here. I like that the left and right buttons are clear. I think that's pretty. I think the whole thing is pretty. It's really thin. When I first got the Birth by Sleep, I locked myself away basically for 100 hours. No one talked to me. I just did this. My favorite character from that game was Aqua. And Ven. Axel and Chun. I think that's how you say it, right? It's on the wire. It's X-I-O-N. And I say Chun. Chun. Yeah. So guys, I'm going to call it a night because the bug is on the table right now. And I want to leave, so...